Hello, my friends. If you want to learn how to create a rate confirmation in just 7 minutes from scratch, you're in the right place. When you're ready to enter in your first load into LoadManager TMS software, it is super easy. You could do it all from one screen. You click the Add Load button right here, and then you can go ahead and enter in the amount of the load, and then how much you would pay either your carrier or a customer. And then you're gonna enter in who's gonna pay for the load. In this instance, it's gonna be Legacy Manufacturing. Notices, by the way, that it says there's no matching customer found. Do I want to add it? I would click OK. If the customer was already in the system, it would have just pulled it onto the load from a drop down. We're going to set the default dispatcher and sales rep accordingly. And then I'm going to enter in the address. And this is Concord Avenue. And that is located in the Bronx. Zip code is 10455. And you'll notice I get a drop down, which I could just select. And the contact person, I'm going to put in accordingly. And we're going to also put in the phone number. This is just fake information I'm just making up as an example. And then we can put in a email address and click save. Now that's saved for all future loads. Now we have to say where we're gonna pick it up from. Turns out it's gonna be from the same location, and we're gonna pick that up on the 13th, and we wanna pick up by 0800, and we want to deliver it to one of the Ace Hardwares over here in Smithtown. Now, if you notice, that was already in the system, so I didn't have to type in all the information. And from here, I'm just gonna go ahead and put in the delivery date. Notice it doesn't let me backdate it, so that helps to avoid any errors. We're just gonna say as soon as possible. And we can then define what we're going to be picking up. So in this case, we're picking up a commodity of plastics. So we'll say 12 pallets of plastic, and that's going to weigh 1,200 pounds. And then we're also going to add in a lumper fee for loading that onto the truck. And the lumper fee is going to be, we'll charge the customer $150 and we'll pay the carrier $100. And you can see I've been assigned a load number, and the load is an active load in our system. We could also view it on our My Load screen. You can see it's right here, so it shows on our load board. And now the very next step we'd want to do is post this to one of the load boards. And we can do that by clicking these boxes here and clicking save. And now let's say we did get a response and we have a new carrier that we're ready to enter into our system. To do that, we simply go to the carrier screen and we click the carrier menu rather, and we click add carrier. If you have carrier lookout, then all you have to do is enter in the MC number, which in this case is going to be 1047648, and click continue. And Load Manager will pull down that information via carrier lookout. And you can see that this company has a green indicator, a green light, and it pulls down the basic information. We do have a carrier lookout tab, which will show their insurance information, as well as the past history of insurance, their BASIC scores, and then any crash summary and history information. So now that we have Creator and Sons Trucking, we can just go right back to the load. We're gonna open it up. We're gonna go down to the carrier section, and we're gonna type in the name. And you can see it comes up on the drop down. And we're gonna say, we're gonna use our ET trailer for that. At this point, the status automatically changed to booked, and it also made a note in our dispatch notes here, and I can go ahead and save it, and now I'm ready to dispatch it. I can click the Raycon button, and that shows the pickup and delivery information and how much it is and all the terms associated with that. And so I could go ahead and send that Raycon over to the carrier. I could also email it. I can text the detailed pickup and delivery information to their driver. And I can also do a mobile Raycon for dispatching. Now, when we do a mobile Raycon for dispatching, if we use our native mobile app, we can track the GPS location of the driver. If we use the web mobile app, we can get all the same features of our mobile app, but it will not do the GPS background tracking. So now, just to follow through to the life cycle of the load, we've dispatched it. Now the GPS and the mobile app will automatically update the arrived and departed locations for each stop based upon Geo-Fence feature. If you don't have that, then you could just update it yourself manually when you do your check calls. Once it's finally delivered, we typically change it to a POD status so we can know that we're trying to locate the signed bill of lading and any other billable documents that we need for the proof of delivery. And then with that in place, we would go ahead and attach those files. We would add the file, the proof of delivery, to the load, and we would mark this as a billing document, and we would upload it. And then we would set this to an invoice status. And at this point, now we're ready to do our invoice, which we could also email. And when we email, it's going to include the actual invoice. And it's also going to include the proof of delivery that can be emailed directly to the customer. And of course, you could also just print this button, click this button to print it out, and you could do a paper copy or download it and email it from your regular email. And then once that's all done, you can just mark this as being completed, and you can save and exit, and you can work on your next load on your load board.